disk out button, and it totally freaking screwed my recording and my game. So yeah. We're gonna do the TKTV together.
Welcome to our season finale episode of NBA 2K TV. Today we have our 2K TV Hey Guys Awards with some amazing one-of-a-kind prizes for you guys because you have totally earned it. And if that's not enough, we have a sneak peek at some of the features in 2K17. Now let's jump into our 2K TV Hey Guys Awards. All of the winners today will receive one of these awesome gifts behind me plus a huge VC reward. We asked you on social media to submit which awards you wanted our first award, Most Wins in Gauntlet. And the winner is Eddie, 1230697.
I had no idea it was that many, by the way. It's just so much fun.
Congrats, Eddie. You will be winning a signed jersey from NBA 2K16 cover athlete James Harden.
Oh, wow. Wow. Thank you, guys. Like, you guys blew my mind. I thought you guys made my day, but that just made my whole year, man.
And our next category is Most Wins in Play Now.
No, I accidentally clicked the freaking trigger!
And our winner is Backroad 695. You will be winning a signed John Wall jersey. Next up, we have most games played in blacktop mode. Congrats to Sir Charles 18863. You will be receiving an exclusive boombox complete with the entire NBA 2K16 soundtrack. Now it's time for the most wins and highest rep in My Park Award. And the winner is Young Audie.
Spent a lot of time, a lot of hours, you know, sacrificing a lot of sleep trying to get there. And when I seemed like I was close, you know, being number one, that just motivated me. To go even harder. So, yeah, and the fact that I pulled it off, that's a good feeling. Shout out my boy King Zoom, Guap, and all the people. Glad to help me grind from Legend 1 to Legend 5. My boy, I'm annoying, huh? You know, Rock Nation, Hard Nation. You already know, man. See y'all boys 2K17. We taking over, man.
You will be receiving a signed jersey from our NBA 2K17 cover athlete, Paul George.
Oh, word? That's what's up. Wow, that's what's up. Appreciate y'all. Paul George is the man. Shout out Paul George, man.
And speaking of Paul George, let's take a little break from our awards and chat 2K17.
Pre-orders of NBA 2K17 are available now. We have three massive bundles to choose from: the Early Tip-Off Edition, the Legend Edition, and the Legend Edition Gold. All will come with a ton of goodies, including new free agent cards for my team, where you can try out amazing players like Paul George and, of course, Kobe Bryant. Plus, all three bundles include early tip-off access, meaning you get to jump into the game on Friday, September 16th. That's right, 4 days early.
And now I'm here with Ronnie 2K to get those last-minute details on 2K17. I know you've got the entire scoop.
I'm really excited about NBA 2K17. Finally, we get to play underwater basketball in an underwater arena.
Told you guys about that one. That's a secret. Wasn't supposed to leak that one yet.
I think this is what people have wanted. You know, the other thing that we get to do next year is finally Yeezys are coming to NBA 2K17.
Amazing. I wonder if they'll go as fast in the game as they go in stores.
They don't look good with gray sweats. It's all I wear.
Since we're going with all the scoop, once you hit Legend 74 in my park, you get peeps. There's 74 levels, and he actually could dunk for you if you get tired of playing with real humans. Another feature, finally, locker codes are coming back, and they are time locker codes. They're not user-based, they're actually time locker codes. That's what the community...
This sucks. Let's do a play now. I haven't done those in a while. I'll be going to state.
It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
Greetings, everybody. Welcome to 2K Sports. I'm Ernie Johnson, and it is my pleasure to be with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. Tonight, it's the Washington Wizards as they'll be playing against the Golden State Warriors. Well, for the Warriors, they're looking to come out strong and make their mark early. They have to look at this game as a great opportunity to do just that. Well, for Golden State, they certainly didn't struggle before Steve Kerr became head coach, but since his arrival, he has this team executing one of the most beautiful offenses in the league.
It reminds me a little bit of the triangle. What I mean by that, there's constant motions and cuts in this offensive system. You know, it's much more than just the Splash Brothers shooting up three.
And it's the Wizards on the road for this one with an interconference game today. Home court advantage goes to the Warriors playing here at the Oracle Arena. You're in for a treat as we bring you NBA basketball on 2K Sports. With Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan. So Golden State will get the first possession. So a look at the starters for the Wizards. The talented Wall and Beal team up in the backcourt. Porter is out there with Markieff Morris. And it's Korczak in at the five.
Damn, Curry, I haven't used you ever. But I'm already starting to like it.
Game changers on offense, but Clark, Stephen Curry is clearly one of them.
Well, the plus minus for the Warriors with him on and off
Crunching
the court
Korczak
validates that. It's incredible how much better they are offensively when he's on the floor.
All right. A three after mine. That's good. I got Clay on me.
Washington on D. He dishes it to Green. On the wing, Thompson. Washington with the rebound. It's 3-on-3 on the fast break. Korczak wide open. He fires. Draymond Green pulls it in. Launches a three. And there's Thompson. That's good on the assist by Green.
You want to play threes?
Thompson's
I'll play threes.
Got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. And Beal kicks to Wall. And Thompson sends it back. And it's out of bounds.
Hey, that beat Thompson.
Golden State on D. It's a three-point game.
Certainly not the dream start they were hoping for going four early.
That doesn't fall. Can't drop his first shot.
Yeah, real nice shot selection there. I guess he's working on his buzzer beater form.
That's a reach, but perhaps that is the case. Or maybe he was trying to knock a bird off of the scoreboard.
That's
about
funny.
Right. Because I still can't figure that one out.
No, I see no birds up there.
No.
Fires the three. And that is good. Thompson's got six.
And he's really been working to get those looks, and it's starting to pay off here early on.
Wall against Thompson. Feeds it to Porter. Another shot, and there's the play by Morris inside. Morris has got his second bucket.
And you know what? He doesn't mind getting his hands dirty when it comes to really fighting on the backboard.
It's Curry outside. That's in, coming off the assist from Thompson. 6 points for Steph Curry.
You know, basketball can be a thing of beauty, and the Warriors showed just how gorgeous ball movement can be last year. Every possession looked like a well-orchestrated concert. It was incredibly fun to watch.
A funny thing about Curry that he could be totally off on his shot and he'll still make it.
Outside, Green. Fires the three. Curry.
Oh, I thought that was going
to
go in.
Well, the Warriors did set the ball around very well last year, Clark. They led the league, as Greg was just talking about, led the league in assists per game. It wasn't even close. Oh, 27 assists per game as a team.
Yeah, 28 times they had 30 or more assists. Mm. In 2014, the team that led in that category was the Spurs. They did it only 16 times.
Sorry.
It's 3-on-3 on the fast break.
Who's this?
Walls shot is off.
And typically, he has the touch to finish when he's in tight, but not sure on that possession.
Boga kicks to Thompson.
Barnes is scheduled for a three.
Rebound, Washington.
And here I'm just shooting threes. I should stop. I should really stop. Played.
Porter, no luck.
Yeah, credit the D there.
Oh, my God, I never pressed the button.
On the release.
Who the hell is this? Because I'm about to kill him. Just kidding. Who the hell are you? McCurry, I don't know. I'm just trying to shoot.
Stayed real snug on him and didn't allow him the space he needed to get a good shot off.
Come on, Steph Curry.
Spates comes in for Andrew Bogut.
Okay, why did I do that? Why did I do that? Why did I do that? Why did I do that?
Washington. Dudley's checked in. Now, here's Wall. Looking for his first basket still in this one.
Lane, you know,
the
I just left
has got to do a much better job of fighting over those screens.
And Greg, especially Clay. When the ball is in his hands. I mean, come on now. You know he doesn't miss too many open looks like that.
They get How it. Did he?
Spates.
Spates. No oh good, my God! All right, let's play for real now. Why did I do that?
And he didn't get quite enough under that one.
Play.
And guys, I would have to say one of the most underrated defensive players in the NBA, Draymond Green, might not be the case anymore. After
Go to top corner
the
Curry spot, bro.
Yep, he might not look the part. You know, undersized, but you talk to the scouts and the stat geeks, they'll tell you he's one of the best in the game defensively.
Now here's Curry, following the miss by John Wall. And he gets it to go.
Man, that is not an easy shot right there. I mean, he had to get it off over a much taller defender.
Yeah, he needed to add just a
Dude,
little
Curry.
Loft on
oh
that
my God.
Of the size mismatch.
How defenders he laughs at.
And that one's good by Porter.
That was a mistake
and
there.
And for Green, long arms, great anticipation. We talk about the IQ. Also, the willingness to absorb contact, all part of what makes him special on the defensive end of the floor.
That gives them the lead. And 12 points for Steph Curry.
These defenders had better start closing out on those shooters.
That's two in a row, and we call that a streak.
Wall dishes to Gortat. For three.
Gortat.
And Wall gets
Ooh,
it to
Ooh, that was a good one,
Gortat.
Wall, but...
Wall's got
you know...
Back.
And, you know, now
we don't take your guys kindly here.
All the advanced measures for defense.
Draymond Udala
is one of the best in our game. I mean, and teams are better able to measure
Okay.
Look, you're going to make it all
camera.
Day.
So I think that helped Green when the time came for him.
I like how the machine says it. Look, you're going to make it all day.
Offline with his three. Outside Curry. No good on the ball.
Ah!
A nice first quarter of play. We've seen plenty of offense so far. Washington out in front.
Let's go. Come on. Oh, God. I really suck at this game. So,
said his mother introduced him to the game of basketball at a young age.
I apologize for that.
She definitely put the ball in my hands.
I don't suck, but I'm not the best NBA in the world. Should be practicing with Bradley so we're losing. This is actually the first time me using Golden State.
But I'm not sure some of the more delicate NBA Eagles could handle her trash talking them when she beats them in a game of horse. Bradley's not only got a special J,
Livingston.
He's got a pretty good disposition, too.
Livingston.
Neither team able to build much of a lead up to this point as we start the second quarter. And a moment here to take a look at the scoring breakdown for the Wizards.
And so far, these guys have done a fantastic job finding the open man and getting some easy baskets.
Well, another thing that's immediately gone right for them is their three-point shooting.
Barnes. Again, Rush. Azealia is out there with Harrison Barnes. And there's Barbosa in at the two spot. So that's the group out there for Golden State. Wizards leading by three. Well, looking at the Wizards, they weren't as lauded as other teams last season, but the Wizards were a ferocious group on defense. Numbers support that. Their activity, Greg, could really bother teams.
Yeah, I mean, on the surface, oftentimes people look at them and think offense, but it really was, to your point, Kevin, the defense was the strength of that group. I mean, they do get out in transition, but it was the defense, I thought, that really allowed to become elite.
Mid-range
Washington's
jumper.
Gone 4-6 from outside the arc tonight. Sessions passes to Nene. And he was
That was a fat
chance here now for a three-point play.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
And when you make five in a row in close like that, it also takes pressure off your perimeter guys, too.
Garrett Temple has checked in for Washington.
And he has really come to life here after a slow start in that first quarter.
Wait, what am I doing?
Here's Sessions, and it's blocked. Here's Azili. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one.
Barnes can't get it to go.
The shot's there for him, and he's got to take it. I don't care if he
Let's go, Koo.
That's a shot he has to continue.
Let's go.
Warriors trail by three. Here is Livingston from downtown. Nothing that time.
Oh, he let that go away before he put his hand in my face.
You know, he missed that one. Great shooters have a way of feeling when they've got enough room to pull the trigger.
There's no doubt about it. The defense, you can see him exhaling right now. Fortunate that he didn't knock that one down.
There's the dish to Barnes.
That was a bad pass. Could have been backcourt.
Over to the left wing. Rush outside. That's good. Rush has got his first 3 points of the game. Here in the second quarter, we play Now here's Sessions. He's covered closely. And the nays.
That was a good.
And that's how it's done. I mean, find that hole in the D and then go hard to the right.
Maybe that hole was a little bigger than it should have been.
Well, it was. I mean, a tight game like this one, you'd think they'd have a little more energy at the defensive end than that.
Azili dishes the Rush. That's a big high bouncer and goes in. Rush has got 5 points now this quarter.
I like the way they're working the ball inside because when you do that, you get higher percentage shots and typically good things happen.
You got online, bro.
Dream season can be applied to Steve Kerr's first year. Comes in and sets a franchise record in
wins. Damn it, that was bad. That was bad.
For the Warriors in his first year. Still unreal.
Temple can't get it to go.
And you can see the defenders afraid to kind of get in his way a lot of times when he's on his way to the basket. But on
I think
one,
this is where we should put Curry in.
And for Kerr, so much was made of how much pressure he had to face to get the Warriors to improve. Inheriting that team.
I want to keep Barnes in, though. Barnes is killing it.
He passed that test, though, partner.
Barnes isn't even in.
First time that a rookie head coach has won a title since the NBA.
Barnes is not slow.
I think that says it all right there.
And the Warriors decide to take their first time out here.
Yeah, maybe a change of the game plan right now, looking at some different sets because of the matchups.
Yeah, I agree with you because they're looking to tweak things to maybe get those matchups working in their favor.
Catching up on the changes for Golden State. Andrew Bogut checked in for Festus Azili. Draymond Green comes in for Brandon Rush. Klay Thompson has checked in for Leandro Barbosa. And Curry subbed in for Sean Livingston.
am a champ by Beal.
Oh, no technical for hanging with one hand?
For long if they keep giving up dunks like that.
No, it won't, G. You're right. A glaring error defensively and letting him get all the way to the basket that time.
But it's only 2 points. I mean, it was flashy, no doubt. But still, it only counts for two. Two is all.
That was a nice replay brought to you by Kia. And it's going to be two
free
throws.
There was no contact there, boy.
And the thing about Bradley Beal, when he suits up the entire
There was no contact. See that crowd booing?
Potent, a quick, powerful athlete.
Zero contact.
High basketball IQ. Had the great teaching at Florida. Carries it to the NBA. Opponents have to account for him, I think, on both ends of the floor.
And that's a great point, Kevin. I mean, coming out of college, a lot of people compared him to Ray Allen. I mean, he possesses that next-level smoothness and body control that's often indicative of a true.
I suck so bad. I should stop shooting threes.
There's a screen by Gortat. Here's Dudley. And good. Coming off the
Damn it, Dudley. Okay, we're losing really bad.
And really, the defense didn't do a lot to fight around that screen on that possession.
And here is Barnes. He has 7.
Hey, Curry. You're open.
Outside. Rebounded.
Never mind. I'm fine. I should have faked that.
It's stolen by Green.
But it was stolen by Green.
On the wing, Thompson. Offensive rebound. Green kicks to Barnes. No good.
Oh, no.
Wizards leading by 8.
Beal,
the pass to Dudley. The 3. Beal can't get it to go.
Well, it looks like he's cooled down a bit after hitting those 2 in the first quarter.
Nobody near Barnes. Off target.
That should have been
rate.
In. Honestly.
It just hasn't been a very good day for him, guys. They need him to start burying some of those.
Beal dishes to Dudley. A chance to extend the lead to double digits, but it's no good. Porter with the steal.
My God.
Here's Wall. And so that brings the...
Yes, Kevin, thank you. I'm with Klay Thompson.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, everybody. Ernie Johnson here, joined by Shaquille. A pretty close game for the Wizards throughout the first quarter. Their field goal percentage was a robust 50% in the field. And that'll do it for now as the second half of our game.
The second half just about to get going here. Bradley Beal having a dominant impact in this game.
You just love it when the decision-making is as good as it was there in that first half. Didn't force anything.
Guys, I think here in the second half, though, they may want him to be a little more assertive. Start hunting more for his shot, even the tough one.
So the Wizards 5 right now. The great pair of Wall and Beal are at the guard spots. Marky Morris is out there with Porter. And it's Gortat in at center.
Just a grinder, always doing the dirty work on the offensive glass, and that's one of the things he brings to the table.
There's Porter with the 3. That's good. And so Wall with the assist. Wall's got his 7th assist in the game.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball movement.
Really a prime example of the difference in how these teams have operated offensively. Much more individual play at the other end.
And how about that, responding to the 3-pointer against them with a quick one of their own.
Terrific little tay-to-tay going on right now. Back and forth, here we go.
And for those of you tuning in, we're about a minute into the second half. That's good. Wall's got 4 this quarter.
And good passing, setting up a lot of these buckets right now, Kevin. That's been the key.
Dime-dropping delights is what I call it.
That is a nice pass. I will give you that one.
Yeah, he's on the money. That's no doubt. That one's good, and the Wizards' lead is cut down to 8 on the bucket from Stephen Curry.
And really, the Warriors had an amazing regular season last year. Just from a historical standpoint, it was one of the best ever.
Give it up for them, Arthur Arena, your Warriors girls.
Wizards leading by 8. The feed to Wall. And that one is hammered home.
And, folks, he does more than just put 2 points onto their lead. He does it with a little bit of flair.
He sure does. You're right. It's a dazzling move to the bucket for him.
I tell you what, he may not be the biggest man in the league, guys, but he more than makes up for that lack of size with amazing aerial skills.
And for the Warriors last year, they would end the season with 67 wins. That number, Clark, tying for the 6th best win total in NBA history.
And my guess is only a few people saw it coming. I mean, as the season wore on, it became more and more apparent that the Warriors were for real, but it took a while for people to accept that fact.
Curry. Porter pulls it in. Washington's gone 5-9 when they put up a 3-point shot tonight. To the middle. Deflects the pass. It's stolen by Green. That's in, coming off the assist from Thompson. Green's got 4 points now in the quarter.
One of the reasons they're behind is because we haven't seen enough of that. He needs to become a bigger part of the offense.
And there's the call on Klay Thompson. That'll be his 2nd foul of the game. Brandon Rush, who's checked in for Harrison Barnes. And then for Washington, Nene comes in for Gortat. And it's Thornton in for Otto Porter Jr. Thornton up on top. Back to Wall. Clock at 6. There's Beal with the 3. Can't hit. And Golden State will go the other way with it. Shoots the 3.
Puts up.
Rebound, Washington. Beal's got his 3rd rebound on the night. Let's it go from 11, and it's sent back by Bogut, and they'll keep possession. Tries again. They get it back, and Morris throws
it
down.
Damn it, Morris!
And Kevin, the knack for the offensive rebound, a big part of what makes this guy special.
Not to mention, Greg, his ability to finish with strength just like that.
Yeah, he's
an invaluable asset for him. Why did I shoot that? Why the hell did I shoot that? Tell me.
Early on last year was clear Steph Curry was just at another level, was an MVP candidate right from the start of the season, and he would eventually be voted that award.
And I thought very deserving. You could see how he elevated his play, and so many of us, and so much talk focuses on what he does offensively. Though he was ahead of the snake of a terrific defensive group for Golden State a season ago, and that's one reason why he ended up being the MVP.
Wow, they're leading by a lot.
In the 3rd quarter with just over 3.5 minutes off the clock. Thompson inside the line. Shot is off. Now the Wizards.
Thompson, you weren't even at 3 range.
And they've got a big lead, not just on the scoreboard, but really in the rebounding numbers as well.
And what I like about it, Greg, it's been a physical brand of basketball. It's had a little sandpaper element to it. Gritty and
no
rough.
Way. He would make that forever. Games. I'm getting pissed.
And Thornton kicks to Nene. Beautiful dish, and the layup goes down. Nene's got 6 points.
Almost uncontested. I mean, it's nice to be able to add to the lead without having to really work for it.
Wow.
Didn't think that was going to go in.
And
that's now 20 points for Steph Curry.
And he got loose from the 3-point range in the first half and showing signs here that he's still got the flow in the second. And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Yeah, and that's 4 straight field goals now, Greg. They've allowed.
All right, why don't you shut up?
Can't happen.
Different look here for the Warriors. Spates checked in for Bogut. Iguodala comes in for Brandon Rush. Clark, he's checked in for Klay Thompson. And it's Livingston in for Curry. And then for Washington, Jared Dudley's checked in for Morris. Temple comes in for Marcus Thornton. And Sessions subbed in for John Wall. And again, it's the Warriors missing. 1:14 left to play in the 3rd. Dishes it to Dudley. A 3 ball. Here's Nene. Makes it off the glass.
Hell no, this is such bull.
They're getting on a roll inside. Their last 3 field goals have come from inside the paint area.
There's got to be a wall of defense when it comes to attacking.
Don't even think you can shoot this. Call a timeout.
Plain and simple.
Wizards leading by 17. An intentional foul committed, but for what purpose, Greg? I'm not sure.
A scene of confusion right there. I can't imagine why he thought it was a good idea to foul there.
And the Warriors making a change here. Azili's checked in. Then for the Wizards, Gortat has come in for Nene. And it's Otto Porter Jr. in for Beal. Here's Temple. No good from outside.
Hard to figure out how he doesn't knock that one down. No defender in sight.
Livingston kicks to Azili. Three-pointer. Washington with the rebound. 5 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. And that's an intentional foul.
Yeah, not sure what that was about. I mean, talk about a brain cramp.
Yeah, yeah, completely a brain fade. I don't know where that came from. Just lost sense of time and the situation.
Oh, is that the fourth quarter?
He hits the second from the line. Warriors trail by 18. Livingston kicks to Spates. And he tries off the glass, but it's no good.
I keep forgetting it's my possession. And I can call the timeout.
In the corner, Gortat with it. Here's Temple. Connects on the 17-footer. And the Wizards. He gets it up. And it would have crowded had it fallen, but it's offline. And at the end of the third quarter, a huge lead in this one.
Okay, man, put your hands together.
And thanks again for joining us. Let's see what happens here in the fourth. The Warriors shooting about 33%, not happy with their play on that end. It's the Splash Brothers, Curry and Thompson. They're in the backcourt. Iguodala out there with Festus Ezeli, and it's Barnes in at the three slot. So that's the group out there for Golden State. Fires from 14. The shot no good. Good D by Thompson. And it's Golden State's ball. To the wing right side. Pulls up from the corner. And that one's good. Barnes. Barnes has got the first field goal of the fourth quarter here for the Warriors. And Wall. Here we go now. Last season, a mixed bag for Wall statistically. Some steps forward, but overall, lower numbers.
Yeah, but, you know, he didn't score as much as he had the previous two seasons, but he was more efficient. And sometimes, Kevin, the better your team, the less you have to do, but he clearly is a better player.
Andrew Bogut, he's checked in for the Warriors. Green comes in for Andre Iguodala. Markieff Morris is checked in for the Wizards. Beal comes in for Marcus Thornton.
They've given up a lot of three-pointers here today.
And their defensive rotations have been non-existent. For Wall, guys, he played more of a traditional point guard role, but double-digit assist numbers at 10 a game for him, really strong.
And that bucket adds to what has been a big difference in points in the paint between the two teams.
Yeah, it's really been quite a contrast. I like the way they're attacking the middle at their offensive end.
From 17 feet out, a shot no good. So Golden State will take it the other way.
And also for Wall, his usage was down. I mean, a few less minutes played, fewer shots taken. Overall, though, I thought it was a big step towards becoming more of a traditional point guard, and the Wizards are better for it. He had 6 points from long range in the first half, but nothing's fallen here since.
And they go to the intentional foul. A timeout called by Golden State. And the thing, Greg, about Marcin Gortat, he's not a high flyer. He's not a super flexible athlete. But he's one of the best centers in the league because he's tough. And he's worked hard on developing his skills. And he always, always hustles.
Yeah, and he fights for position down low. A terrific screener. Does a lot of that dirty work. And he's also very good at passing the basketball. You know, a lot more skilled, particularly in the pick and roll, that maybe people give him credit for. He can hurt a defense in a surprising number of ways.
Timeout called the Warriors.
Talking about Gortat, he was a late second round draft choice in 2005. His first 4 years in the league, highly underwhelming. Now, over the last 4 years, He's averaged around 13 points, 9 rebounds, and 1.5 blocks per game. Those are good numbers.
Brandon Rush, he's checked in for Green. Shot clock at 6. Washington needs to get a shot off here. Let's it go from the wing. Wall's shot is off.
Well, I think he had all the space he needed. He just couldn't find the bottom of the net.
And getting back to Marcin Gortat, his dad was a successful light heavyweight boxer.
No way.
Poland, so clearly you see where the toughness comes from. And Marcin's mom was on the Polish national team in volleyball. So you know where the blocking and ball skills come from. The old blocks.
Suck at this game so bad. And I can't even beat the computer. Ugh.
And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. The scoring breakdown for the Wizards.
And I like how they've taken the high percentage shot in the paint. In that first half, we saw them doing it, and they've continued to succeed as the game has worn on.
You know, something else I've noticed is just how many of their baskets have been set up by assists throughout the game. And we've all seen how dominant Bradley Beal can be. The third overall pick in the 2012 draft. He's already had a solid young career, but still plenty of room to grow.
Yeah, plenty of room there. How'd you miss it?
Here's Wall. And the basket good.
Wow. That was a really nice shot.
The second half.
And you know what? He's shaking off the cold shooting performance from the first half.
It's Curry outside. Beal pulls it in. Beal's got 6 rebounds here tonight. Talking about Bradley Beal's potential, it's not just the shooting, it's also the passing, and you really don't think of him as a passer, but for such a young two-guard, he's extremely unselfish, averaged over 3 assists a game over the past 2 years.
And the true stars They're of winning our game like 20 feature versus
Stop calling it damn timeout!
Has also Great tremendous point. Upside as a Warriors. Rebound. I mean, how about getting 7 boards almost a game the 1 year he was in college, so he understands the importance of impacting other areas. I mean, last season he had his highest steals average of his career, and everything's upside with this young man. The sky's the limit.
Excellent point. Third minute of action now gone here in the fourth. And Wall kicks to Morris. It's hauled in by Bogut.
The fadeaway was the right shot there because it got his attempt away from the defender, but the touch was poor.
Rush gets the bucket.
And they clearly are just destroying this group right now from the three-point line.
Yeah, and the defense knows it. I mean, they are fully stretched out trying to stop the three-point shot and still haven't been able to do it.
Thompson against Wall. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Andrew Bogut.
A blocking foul.
The game.
And the next one puts him in the bonus.
Yep, they'll be trying to draw that next foul quickly so they can start getting those easy chances at the strike.
Draymond Green, he's checked in for the Warriors. Morris kicks to Wall. Morris a screen. Wall against Thompson. Just 5 on the clock. And there's Beal. That's good on the assist by Wall. 20 points here for Beal.
He's played an important role in their offense today, guys. Without him, they may not be in the league.
Curry gets the bucket.
Wow. What can you say?
Wizards leading by 16.
And that's his 4th, and no doubt he would have liked to have not gotten it this soon.
Well, I think all 3 of us agree, John Wall, a tremendous all-around player.
Outstanding. Speed was what jumped out at me most when I saw him first at Kentucky. Now he's been able to harness that speed as a pro, and he makes plays that very few can make as a point guard.
He gives you a lot of different looks, doesn't he?
He sure does.
And his presence as a scorer, it just has a calming effect for the rest of the team. He's a fallback option whenever they need one.
Up top, Morris, guarded by Green. Morris with the screen for Wall. Here's Beal.
No way!
It's all good. He's attempted 12 shots.
Right, and this is what they wanted. I mean, to announce their presence in this matchup with authority. Very decisive. It can definitely be considered a statement win for the Wizards.
They enjoyed a big boost from the strong play of their bench.
Yeah, I thought the subs came in and did an outstanding job, Kevin. Those points off the bench were huge.
And what a huge standout performance it was for John Wall. A big part of their success was his ability to keep the ball moving, finding guys when they would flash open.
Yeah, with the game out of reach, intentional fouls don't mean anything. It's just an exercise in futility. Let the clock run.
Yeah, I agree with you, Clark. Just doesn't really make a lot of sense at this point.
Well, nobody really knew, Greg, what to make of Washington going into last year's playoffs. They came out strong with a big sweep against a pretty good Raptors team.
It's not your Charger.
Taking them down four straight.
No, it wasn't. Why was it downstairs then?
A team has swept an opponent without...
Because it's your Charger, that's why it's downstairs. That did not even make one bit of sense.
For the Wizards in franchise history. Mm.
Wizards have gone 5 of 10, 50% from the field.
And
now we've got the intentional foul.
Sean Livingston. That's his second personal foul.
And in the second round, the Wizards continued to be a tough opponent. I mean, they went up 2-1 on the Hawks, but were unable to keep the series lead. A lot of close, heartbreaking losses for them in that series.
And the Hawks would ultimately take down the Wizards last year in the postseason. John Wall and his injury were a big turning point in that matchup, and all those buzzer beaters for both teams made it one of the most interesting series of the postseason.
Garrett Temple has checked in for Beal. Livingston, no luck.
Leah Montsari match done. This time it's going to be a good one.
So Golden State will get the first possession. All right, let's set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade. All fueled up and ready to go. Taking a look at the Wizards. The great pair of Wall and Beal are at the guard spots. Marquise Morris is out there with Otto Porter Jr. And it's Gortat in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. Now Wall. After the missed three from Stephen Curry. No good. Good D by Thompson. And for Marquise Gortat,
he was
such a big fit for the Wizards last season. Actually, the last two seasons.
You know, he runs the floor very well for his size. A terrific finisher, solid in the pick and roll, can make the mid-range. You know, he's been one of the more consistent centers in our league.
Now here's Beal after Gortat's miss. And it's Harrison Barnes with the foul. That's his first foul.
Oh, my God, Barnes.
In the opening quarter.
You've got to be kidding me. I got the rebound and everything.
The feed to Beal. Back to Wall. Let's a floater go, and the layup is up and in. Wall's got the game going with his first points of the game for Washington. First quarter of play, 1 minute played. For the three. And that's good. Steph Curry for three.
Guys, that's just really unstoppable. He poses a ton of matchup problems for whomever he's facing.
Gortat with the screen for Wall. And that's collected by Bogut.
And that was a difficult shot from mid-range simply because the defense was engaged.
Yeah, and I think the quickness of the
you suck at passing.
Really
threw him off. Oh, my God. Freaking Bogut.
For Washington, they've gone just 1-4 to get this game started. Wall dishes to Gortat.
Munching Gortat.
Kicks it to Beal. Launches it. And that one's good.
Oh, you want to come back with your own three? Oh, okay. Okay.
Good open look, and he splashes home the three.
Despite an overall strong year in 2015 for the Wizards, they
were pretty weak at times.
Clark on the road.
Managed only 17 wins away from home, tied the Pelicans for the fewest road wins for any team that actually made the playoffs last year.
Golden State's gone 1-3 from beyond the arc so far in the game. Passes it to Thompson. Launches a three, and there's Stephen Curry on the assist by Thompson. And that's now 6 points for Steph Curry.
And for the Wizards and their road problems, a lot of it came from their inability to defend the three. I mean, they were in the bottom third in the league at defending the three as the road team. And that would have been lucky had it fallen poor shot selection.
Yeah, look at the coach's face and the expression. It says all over it. Are you kidding me?
Beal's shot is good. Golden State's gone 2-4 from beyond the arc to start the game.
And you know what's odd about the Wizards' road problems is that they play outstanding defense otherwise. I mean, compared to 2014, they definitely took a step backwards in regards to their role play last season.
Good.
In.
8 points for Steph Curry.
And off to a strong start offensively. He's got a nice touch.
Let's catch up with Doris from the sideline.
Thank you, Kevin. Randy Whitman and I spoke just briefly. One player that he's talked to his guys a lot about is Stephen Curry. He said Curry's one of the premier shooters in the game, and he's got that quick trigger. We really have to be tight to him, get physical, and try to get him on his heels as much as possible.
What?
Guys, Curry is an excellent free throw shooter. We'll see if they can do that without fouling him.
All right, Doris. Took him no time at all on that one. Guys, no one team gaining control early on.
Give and take, back and forth, the whole way thus far.
Yeah, you look at the lead changes, 6 already.
Now, here's Curry. He's got 8. Outside, Green. Nailed from three-point land.
Tit for tat right there, huh, guys?
Didn't take him long at all, fellas, to get those
three
points.
Wow, it's sad how Green can make Morris, that. Outside.
Pass to Beal. All alone. Beal can't get that one to fall.
No doubt he's struggling right now from the field. Let's see if he can get it going this quarter.
And despite some of the injuries over the years, Andrew Bogut still one of the game's best shot blockers, averaging well over 2.5 a game in his career. And Greg, he protects the rim like few others can, a rugged player.
And in last season, almost 3 block shots per game. And with all the offensive firepower around him, I think it really allows him to play to his strengths. That's why having a great team is about pieces of the puzzle fitting. He's a terrific piece for this group.
So timeout called here, the first for Washington.
And getting back to Bogut, people forget he's a pretty good athlete. The reason he was drafted number 1 overall way back when was because of his insane combination of size and movement skills. That's why he remains one of the excellent shot blockers in the league today.
Spates checked in for Golden State. Iguodala comes in for Barnes. And a new group getting ready to come in for Washington. Nene, he's checked in for Gortat. Dudley comes in for Morris. Marcus Thornton, he's checked in for Porter. And Sessions subbed in for John Wall. Now here's Sessions. Right wing. The 3 from Dudley. That falls. Great assist by Ramon Sessions.
And when you talk about Bogut, I think the Warriors' incredible regular season inspired him. He didn't have to be the star. He just had to anchor that deed. Sometimes when you give a guy a specific task to be the best at, that's what he delivers the most.
Garrett Temple has checked in for Bradley Beal. Nene into the lane. An easy 2 points on the layup. No shortage of drama here early on.
Well, neither team can grasp control of this thing. I mean, both teams trying to get a hold of it.
Yeah, 8 lead changes already. Huge number this early. And you know what? Just a little too much heat on that pass for him to come up with the steal.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, that was going to be a tough catch for either one of them.
Outside Curry. And another 3 for Golden State.
And he's starting to show that killer instinct this quarter, looking to extend the lead.
Curry against Sessions. From the high post. And the Wizards getting another bucket right there. There's 38 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Curry outside. Rebounded by the Wizards.
Oh, he can't make them all, though.
Tell you what, they haven't wasted any time getting into the swing of things on the boards.
And even this early, that's a good omen for the rest of the game.
And the shot's good from Nene.
This has been a thriller. You cannot say enough about the way these two teams have competed.
All indications, Greg, are that this game is going down to the wire. I mean, I'd be surprised, actually shocked, if it ended any other way.
He muscles it in through the contact, and they call the foul. And he's on his way to the free throw line.
No clue how he got that one to fall.
And that was not a soft foul he had to get through, Greg. I mean, he had to really power that one up and in.
On the wing, Green. They need this. And a great assist by Curry as that one goes in. Green's got five.
Not much defense to speak of yet here, guys.
Nope.
Charging foul.
All the time here early.
Oh, great defense. They anticipated the play and got there first.
And not afraid to put his body on the line either, Greg. He took a shot for the team in that situation.
Plenty of...
What? Okay, so he shot it. Oh, crap. No, no one saw that go right through whatever the hell his name is. I think it was Waller Morris.
And a chance now to hear from the Brazilian big man, Nene, about the development.
Nene!
With Nene and the Mets, that team is indeed capable and talented and can do some very special things.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, he's in a supporting role. And when he steps up in a big way, he gives them an X factor.
And we got a close game here as we get back to the second quarter. And an important part of every team's game, a look at the hustle stats for Washington.
It looks like they're ready to run, fellas. I mean, they haven't hesitated at all to get out on the break so far.
And also, they're jumping on a lot of turnovers, making sure they turn them into points at the other end.
They've got Harrison Barnes. Azealia's out there with Iguodala. And there's Livingston. And it's Barbosa in at the two. That's the Warriors' five. When you think about Sean Livingston, you think about the career that might have been an absolute rising star after being taken Clark fourth back in the 2004 draft.
Kevin, he was averaging over five assists a game as a teenager.
Barnes, are you freaking kidding me?
Every year, then the devastating knee injury. Just great to see him back playing basketball.
Brandon Rush, he's checked in for the Warriors. Markieff Morris has checked in for the Wizards. Bradley Beal comes in for Garrett Temple. Whoops, anticipated the pass. Turnover. Barbosa against Beal. Barbosa kicks to Livingston. Pass to Azili. Six to shoot. Barnes with it. Guarded now by Morris. Barnes can't get it to go.
And getting back to Livingston, he's had comeback after comeback. I mean, each time he'd start to flash those unbelievable movement skills, he'd get injured again. It's a shame because he was on the path to becoming one of the game's great young point guards.
It's deflected. Beal with the steal. And here we go, the Wizards' fast break. Gets that one to drop. That's his third field goal in eight tries.
Another bucket in the paint. That's something they just have not been able to stop today.
Yeah, the defense is all about disrupting timing and spacing, and what they've got going right now is not getting
no
it done.
Kicking foul. I almost just hit a kicking foul.
Barbosa against Porter.
No kickball violation.
Hits the 3-point bomb.
Oh my God.
Now it's a 7-point Wizards lead.
Timeout. And for Livingston, last season with the Warriors was a dream. He got to back up Steph. So he got to play against second stringers, and we got to see flashes of his dominant traits again. What a happy ending for him.
Oh, why would you say that?
And as the coaches go to the clipboard to outline their strategy during the timeout, the players getting a chance to rehydrate with some Gatorade. That's key to staying fresh all the way to the final whistle.
And, Kevin, it really is. And every one of these players knows it. They're all making sure to stay hydrated. It's impossible to play your A game if you're not getting enough to drink, especially towards the end of games when the physical toll of a long contest really starts to add up.
Thompson has jumped in for Golden State. Curry comes in for Sean Livingston. Curry against Wall. Fires for three. Rush the pass to Barnes. Inside. That one's good. And the Washington lead is cut to just 5 points in the basket from Rush.
He was the first one to react to that miss. Excellent anticipation on his part. A hustle play on the putback by him.
Morris outside. It's Beal on the wing. Morris a screen. And Barnes comes to help. Just five on the clock. Here's Porter. It will not find the hoop. It's his third miss. He has made two. It was the season of destiny, and the Warriors certainly followed through, Clark, the best team in the league all year, and they finished the job beating the Cavs in the finals.
And they were on a mission from the get-go. They would become another team to win 65 games or more and win the finals. Impressive work.
Thompson outside. Back to Curry from outside the arc. Shot is off. Wall with some nice D.
And you know what? He's just not on his game, no doubt about it. Their deficit isn't totally on him, but he has not been an asset for his team.
Here's Gortat. And the rebound goes to the Warriors. Thompson's got three rebounds now in this one. Curry dishes to Barnes. He drains the quick shot. Washington calls timeout.
And some of Harrison Barnes' teammates have referred to him as the senator because of the way he carries himself. And, you know, a very level-headed, dignified young man. And just he has an air about him.
Here's what Washington's going with right now. Nene, he's checked in for Gortat. Thornton comes in for Porter. And Sessions subbed in for John Wall. Nene, the screen. Off the screen. The Wizards with another miss. And Harrison Barnes at times has been criticized in the past for not being more, Clark, assertive on the court.
Well, you know, it's interesting. He had to weather the pressure of expectations since high school. I mean, people were comparing him to Kobe Bryant back then, but HB can't get caught up in that. He's got to be true to himself. You know what I tell guys? Do you.
Yeah.
Do you.
And, guys, the wheels really fell off for Marcus Thornton's game last year. This was a deadly shooter who averaged over 21 points a game only a few seasons ago. But last season, under double figures at 9 per contest.
Looking at who's out there now for the Warriors. Spates checked in for Festus Ezeli. Green comes in for Harrison Barnes. And it's Iguodala in for Brandon Rush. Here's Sessions. Finish off
no
the break.
Fucking way.
And it's a 9-point Wizards lead.
Well, that fast break went according to plan.
Yeah, nice job there, Greg. Recognizing the opportunity was there to push it, and then excellent execution.
Green kicks.
Liam Masip, my friend, requests Diamondman 3-1-2.
Woo!
Let's the three fly, and that one's good. Curry's got 17.
Huh? Who said who friend request? Oh no, damn well, I didn't get a friend request. Who the hell is this? Alan Bibb. And accept my friend requests. Diamond Man 312. Okay, so Oh my god, Thomas, stop sending me crap. This bad thing. Then, man, I'll accept yours. I accepted it, Alan.
Last season, he wasn't all bad. He did hit, you know, a career-high 42% of his threes. Clark, the problem is he didn't provide anything else.
Yeah, he's
I'm gonna change something. Advanced settings. That is better.
I mean, he's never been a great playmaker, rebounder, or defender. His money is made with his jump shot.
Here's Curry with the three. Washington takes it the other way.
It's me, Alan, who used to watch Angry Grandpa streams. Who used to watch your Angry
Grandpa. They still can go 2-for-1.
Boy, they've got to go fast. They must hurry from here.
Beal can't get it to go.
Not able to find it here in the second. He's off stride and off track just a bit after that one he had earlier.
Iguodala, no good.
Those are chances.
Don't foul him.
To get you 2 points, but just enough.
Call a timeout.
I mean, talk about a brain cramp.
Yeah. Yeah, completely.
Oh, don't sub out Curry.
I don't know where that came from. Just lost sense of time.
Get him out.
The situation.
Looking at who's out there now for the Warriors. Ian Clark's checked in for
Get him.
And it's Livingston in for Steph Curry. Iguodala, wide open.
Splash.
Another miss by Iguodala. Here's Thornton. That ball's great assist by Ramon Sessions. Sessions has got 5 assists in the game. Iguodala outside. Temple.
Nope!
And so we wrap up the first half. It's the Wizards. They're up by 10.
Yes, I do. I don't play it, though, at all. On the sideline, of course. I think it's one of the worst games I've ever bought.
Steph, what has the problem been defensively?
We're a step late, I think. And, you know, they made tough shots. Curry. You can't take away from that. But
Steph Curry with shots.
To guard that line if they're knocking down shots. And keep them out.
Steph, thanks for the time. Guys, over to you.
Thanks, Doris. And we'll be back shortly following halftime to get the third quarter started.
Oh, goddamn, goddamn, Allen, boo. Who the hell is that, boo? Huh? Who the hell is that, boo?
Ernie Johnson here again with Kenny Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. We welcome you back to the 2K. A pretty close game for the Wizards throughout the first quarter. Their largest deficit of the period was just 4 points. And that's going to do it for now as the second half is almost ready to get started. Back to Kevin Harlan and the rest of the 2K Sports crew. We're going to sit right here and wait for the end of the game and talk at you again.
Yo, lit.
Now the second half.
You got to get him. You got to get him.
Really incredible game from Stephen Curry.
I know we've said this many times before, but
Curry!
What a great first half. Just an offensive juggernaut.
And, you know, in the end, I wouldn't be surprised if we're talking about what a great second half he had, guys. I mean, he can usually keep it going for all four quarters.
So, the Wizards five right now. The talented Wall and Beal team up in the backcourt. Markieff Morris is out there with Gortat, and it's Porter in at the three slot. Down low. That's tipped. It's stolen by Morris. And we have an intentional foul there, G.A.
What the hell, Green?
It's a one.
That one's pretty strange. I mean,
I'm going to eat your blue jam and freaking shove it to you in your freaking face. You big butt. Anyway.
Now, here's Wall. Out to the right wing. There's Porter with a three. And that comes off the assist by John Wall. So
you want to play NBA 2K16 tomorrow? I got now in this one. And DLC 3 trailer.
So far,
BLC
we've
release.
Seen them be a bit careless with the ball.
Untidy.
You got to value the possession of the basketball.
Simply put, out of control. This is how they play thus far. They're going to have to reel it in and show some more discipline.
So many great statistics are available to demonstrate just how dominant the Warriors were last season. My favorite is GA, their point differential.
You know, to be able to beat your opponent by double digits on average is something only 8 teams have been able to do.
Yeah, sure, I'll play 2K tomorrow.
It's amazing.
Guys, the Warriors ended the year at just over a 10-point differential per game. I mean, still that number is staggering. When you think of what it takes to achieve that mark over the course of a season, typically championship teams are somewhere in the +6 to +8 range. 10 is off the charts.
And he gets the bucket.
Consistency all game long. He's going to continue, I think, to have to take it over to get them back in the game.
To the inside, here's Morris. So he gets the whistle, contact on the way up, and two shots coming up.
And you know what? That Warriors point differential was helped out a lot by their play at home. The home differential was almost +15 points per game. A lot of blowout wins. Scary thing is they set their starters in the fourth so often, they could have made those numbers even higher had they won it.
And he sinks the second. Last season at both sides of the coin for the Wizards started out very hot, but then just could not keep it going.
Well, you know, the start was extremely hot, 19-6, which tied a franchise best in that record. After that, though, they played close to 500 ball the rest of the time.
Washington leading now by 11. Outside, Wall takes a three. Gortat, no good.
Woo!
State will come the other way. To the paint. Wall with the steal. Beal, the pass to Gortat. And there's the whistle. Foul on the shot. He'll go to the line.
And the Wizards really struggled post All-Star break, playing under 500.
Okay.
Still, though, they seem to pull things together at the very end and on into the postseason.
Well, there's no denying it.
You go ahead, buddy.
Bumps, and you mentioned that. Some weeks they look like a lottery team. Then the next, they look like a title contender. They knew how to make the most of their games when they did get hot, though.
And no good on the second free throw, so he goes 0 for 2 there.
And guys, one thing that was obvious to me, last year the Wizards really matured as a team. I mean, they played as if they expected to win instead of a group kind of coming into their own.
Yeah.
I thought they just showed a lot more composure and maturity on the court.
Warriors trail by 11. Thompson outside. The pass to Bogut. Back to Thompson. 14 feet away. Good as the jump shot falls.
Oh, that was a quick trailer. Damn.
First points in this one.
Everything going to plan here to start the third. 80% shooting thus far.
Washington calls timeout. As you said, the Wizards did look more mature last year on the floor with their play. They made sure to add veterans to achieve that.
And not just any veteran, but a future Hall of Famer in Paul
Pierce.
Are
they actually?
I mean, his presence on the team,
so
I
sick.
Think, really is what propelled
him to achieve.
And it also went beyond just Paul Pierce. That roster had a combined 490 playoff games. And that playoff veteran leadership, I felt, really helped this young core to grow.
And the wide-open shot from Green.
Oh, come on, Green. That was perfect. It wasn't trailing.
Washington leading
by 11.
Okay. Porter kicks to Morris.
Ah.
There's three-pointers off the mark.
You can't get in a much better position for the three than that. Everything was right on target. It just didn't fall.
It's Curry outside, and that one's good. Curry's got 20.
Really good job of
Curry. Yeah, that would be sick.
Just enough space
to
let that one fly.
And Wall kicks to Beal. Shot, high post, and the rejection by Azili. And that is good. 22 points for Steph Curry. Washington has gotten a lot of looks from outside tonight. 5 of 12. Wall against Curry. Outside, Wall. Jacks up a three.
Jacks up a three.
Leandro Barbosa with the rebound.
You know what, though? Sometimes you can be too open. I think it may have surprised him, and that's why he missed. And John Wall, guys, is still one of the most explosive players in the league. His speed makes professional athletes look like they are stuck in mud.
Morris with the bucket.
Great unspoken communication between teammates leading to the nice assist and the easy score.
Warriors
yeah, that would be
eight.
Six. They actually.
It's Curry outside and another three for
like
Golden State.
Yeah, I would love to see Ray Jack in
a Wall's burst. He can go end to end in seconds. Clark, you're amazed. You say he's a blur.
Yeah, rack to rack in a nanosecond is what Wall can do. I mean, his speed is something special.
Just not there from a rhythm standpoint right now. It's really eluding.
Oh, I'm catching up
size-wise, but the incredible skill that he possesses allows that one to go.
Well, the quick high release negated any height disadvantage he had right there.
There's a screen by Gortat. It's Wall with the drive. Nice job coming off that screen. Wall's got his second basket of the game.
Yeah.
Perfect screen there. Setting
up right,
with a terrific look.
Yeah, I like the
That'd
fact
nice.
That the setup was good, the screen was solid, but you also have to look at the fact the defender didn't do his job as well as he could have. That's far too good a look to give them from behind the arc.
Three
I'm
going to
check out that Twitter post.
Come from beyond the arc. The defense has to react quicker.
Beal dishes to Morris. They set the pick. There's a screen by Gortat. Shot clock at 5. Here's Porter. Green with the rebound. Green's got 4 rebounds now tonight. Here's Curry with the 3.
That was a bad shot.
Wall grabs the board. Down low. And the rejection by Azili. Out of bounds. Wizards ball as Washington keeps possession.
Yeah, I'm going to search that up after this video, dude. I was planning on finishing this game because I haven't beaten the Wizards.
Sessions. Off the mark.
And that the third went quarter, from a 20-point lead to a 2-point lead.
And coming up is soon as...
Which is going to be sick. Oh.
And thanks for joining
by the way,
us
there's a 30-second delay from me saying something and from you getting it on the actual stream, so... Yeah.
The Warriors trailing. Livingston is out there with Ian Clark. Then there's Iguodala. Then there's Maurice Spates, and it's Bogut in at the 5, home in the paint. That's the Warriors' 5. No good from Spates.
Usually
they got the shot they wanted off of that pick, but it just doesn't fall.
Yeah, it didn't go down, but you'll take that shot every single time, Greg. That's good offense.
Okay, so, what's my subs? Okay, so it's sliders now. Settings now. Substitutions, dude. How did I miss that? Clay hasn't been doing good, so I'm gonna put him here. Iguodala, yeah, I'll keep him in. Well, Green. What is he? I stream on YouTube. We can both do a stream on NBA Kids. Yeah, that'd be sick, dude. No, no, no! Don't cancel! Oh my god, okay. Clark, Curry, Green. Confirm. Yeah, we could we'll stream.
And for Jerry Dudley, a bit of a resurgence last season. Found a team he liked playing for, played much closer to his career numbers than the year before with the Clippers.
Yeah, and that's a great point. I mean, he turned back the clock in almost every category. And I think, to your point, a lot of it has to do with the fit. He's on a team in a role that suits his talent. And I think you're going to see him continue to be consistent.
Looking at his after now for the Warriors.
70. Yeah, I'm at like 77. I'm not sure anymore. Last time I checked, I was at 77. I probably went down. My channel is slowly dying. Just kidding. It was never loud.
Yeah, you hope that's not indicative of the type of D they're going to play, because they do, they're going to have struggles with him tonight.
That was the worst pass of your damn life, Livingston. I should take you out for that.
Wizards leading by 3.
And, you know, going back to Jared Dudley, he helps you in so many different ways. Shoots a lot of threes, yet does so efficiently. He rebounds, he passes the ball.
Ooh!
Physical, too. He's a valuable vet to have in your locker room.
Warriors shooting reasonably well, 45%. Curry kicks to Green.
Right over him.
Gets the assist. And that's now 17 points for Draymond
Green. Okay,
thank
God.
Wizards have gone 1-3 from the field to start the fourth quarter.
And you know what?
Yeah, so tell your friends about my channel, Alan.
The junkyard.
Tell them to subscribe.
I mean, toughness and that
because Trace kind of surpassed me in one night. He got 70 subscribers literally in one day. I think it was more than 70. He's at like 120 now.
And Steph Curry, not just a superstar player, but one of the best contracts.
You can help me build my channel right back up.
For under $24 million combined, and you can bet.
And for my
major increase in pay
for my 100 subscriber special, I will do the hottest chili pepper in the world challenge. That will be something that I'm going to do.
I got a chance to hear what
I haven't done a subscriber special ever.
He was highly animated.
I should have done one at 15.
Them, telling them this is going to be a huge win for us. When we close this out, it will go a long way towards showing the rest of the league what we're capable of.
And thank you, Doris. Wizards making a switch here. Morris has checked in. And for Stephen Curry, a value contract, but a growing list of endorsements. One of the top-selling jerseys in the league, a signature shoe deal. He's doing all right.
Yeah, I don't think he's worried about it. He's got a Bible quotation on his wrist that says, love never fails. And that's how he approaches the game, with a true love and faith that his hard work is going to pay off.
Come on!
That
yeah!
was good.
That's two straight quick three-pointers they've allowed.
Defense just not reacting with enough aggressiveness.
Morris right side. Offensive rebound. Dudley's shot is good.
Ooh.
And you can just
ooh,
see by
this.
The way he fought.
Allen, this is going to be
a lot of gas in
all right, boy.
Livingston passes to Bogut. Fourth quarter of play, and we're about 2.5 minutes through it right now.
That's
that
exactly how
shot.
You win the rebound
shot.
Battle. Get good position, and then use your strength to hold on to that position.
Should have set a pick and roll.
And Wall kicks to Beal. And good, coming off the assist.
No!
Wall's got 6 assists now in the
no,
game.
I don't want to call a timeout.
There, and he didn't waste it, his second three of the game.
Now a timeout called by Golden State.
He's been very untidy with the ball here. Commit turnovers when you try to do too much or you force it. They need to focus on making the simple play, good passes, and moving the ball around.
And some changes here for the Warriors. Barnes, he's checked in for Iguodala. And it's Thompson in for Sean Livingston. Otto Porter Jr.
Three.
He's checked in for Washington.
No!
Washington leading now by 3.
Banana Sprite.
Beal dishes the wall. There's Porter
no.
with the 3. Here's Gortat. Bust up.
No.
Finish.
Oh, I just lost it. I lost
big time
my I lost
mismatch
it.
It's been in the post. Where's the defensive adjustment? They're getting housed down there.
Yeah, something's got to change. A double team, maybe a substitution, but this is getting out of hand.
Washington's gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. Green with the block. Second shot opportunity. Gortat misses.
Oh, that's terrific defense there. That's how you protect the rim.
Curry passes to Thompson. Gets it to go from 18 feet away.
They're shooting it quite well now. Again, function of shot selection, ball move.
You know what? You know what to do at the con. Oh, yeah, I know what to do at the con.
Guys are in rhythm, confident, free-flowing, and they're knocking down their shots.
Here's Morris. They get a hand on it and stolen by Barnes. On its way from Curry for 2. Some nice D.
You know, not only is the game neck and neck and tight, but the rebounding battle is too. Extremely close on the board.
It's been brutal in terms of the physicality down low.
Oh, that's disgusting. I'll
Beal
cry.
Beal can't get it to go.
Well, I like the defense there. Right up in his grill, didn't give him a chance.
Green with the ball. Guarded now by Morris. It's 3 outside.
No way! Dude, oh!
By 3. It's Beal on the wing. No one near Wall as he lets it go. And again, Washington, no good. The Warriors shooting a pedestrian 36% in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, it was all fake thingy. He basically admitted it.
Curry's got the game tied.
With his new videos.
What's gotten into him today?
His dad
did. This is getting ridiculous.
Honestly retarded.
Washington calls timeout.
64-64. Just got to hold this lead. Or hold this tie. Hold this tie and try to score an extra point. Waste the clock. Waste the clock. Ooh, this is really freaking intense.
Wall.
No, no, no.
Morris with a screen on Curry. Wall.
No!
Warriors pull it in. Outside Curry. Open shot. Green buries it.
As clutch a shot as I have ever seen.
In a word, gutsy.
Oh, God. Washington, my God.
Calls timeout. They're behind by two. 58 seconds left in the fourth quarter.
You see this guy jumping around like a damn monkey?
58 seconds left in the fourth. Wall attacking. It's good.
Okay, it's good. It's good. Crap.
To tie it up.
This is John Wall that is on fire.
Damn it.
The Warriors have gone 6 of 13, so just above 46% on their field goal attempts are in the quarter.
No!
Team perimeter defense there. That was a well contested shot.
Yeah, and you know he takes a lot of pride in his defense. There are no easy threes if he's on you.
No way. Freaking hell.
You just don't see from that one spot every day.
Well, that's why he is such an uncommon talent.
Yep, uncommon and unparalleled. I mean, he makes things happen out there for sure.
Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. Curry with it. Beyond the arc. The three won't fall. And they foul intentionally. They're going to have to do that now again and again. They're not in the penalty yet.
Yeah, you can't let them hold the ball and just milk those last seconds away.
No, you got to foul. I mean, it's going to come down to free throws here. Foul right away.
And he misses the first one. He wanted that one to fall. And the second of two is good.
Still have a chance.
To the 3-point lead. Timeout called the Warriors. They trail by three. 12 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Guys, what's your take?
And you know what? You've got a couple options here. You can take the three to tie it or get the quick two and then a five.
And, you know, if it opens up for them inside, the quick two would be the way I would lean, Greg, but the foul has to come immediately.
No!
Oh, he had a chance there to send it to overtime, but they come up empty-handed. And so it's Washington who scraped by with the win. This win, such a tremendous
amount. No!
Really an accomplishment.
Curry, damn it.
Crazy finish to take a road game like this and simply deflate an entire
building. And that about wraps it up. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, Clark Kellogg, and the rest of our terrific 2K Sports crew.
Thank you, Alan.
This is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching.
So screw you, Kevin Harlan. That could have went overtime.
2K Sports post-game.
Damn it.
Kevin, much appreciated, and now let's present our Jordan player of the game, John Wall. He notched his season high, and his scoring really seemed to set the tempo.
All right, thank you guys so much for watching this video. Like if you enjoyed, favoriting, and I forgot about that. Like if you enjoyed, subscribe for more, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Goodbye. Oh, crap, that was hell!